Hey, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to show you the video gears I use to film my videos. If you are a content creator, you're thinking about upgrading your gears or buying some extra equipment to upgrade the quality of your videos, make sure you watch this video until the end. Now, without further ado, let's get into it. First thing, you need a really good camera body, and my favorite is the prosumer range of Canon. So I use the 60D 10 years ago, and then last year I bought a 70D and then an 80D. I like them because the camera body has a really fair photo quality. At the same time, it has a very good video feature. It's not 4K, it's only HD, but for most of content creators, I think it is okay in 2020 to still have just the HD. And also my computer, when I travel, I use a old MacBook Pro, so I don't have a lot of capacity to edit 4K videos anyway. So that's another reason that I don't use 4K, and I'm happy with this Canon 80D for now. And what I like most out of those range cameras is the horizontal flip screen, because I find it really useful when I film myself. I don't need a camera person to help me. I don't need to ask help from anyone else. And I just carry a camera around and I can shoot myself everything autonomously, which is really important. It saves you a lot of money and time. And I've tried other kind of flip screens, such as flipping up and flipping down. I absolutely don't find the sense of why people design those kind of flip screens, because I think it's not useful. I cannot use a microphone at the same time, just because it will block the view of the screen. And the flipping downstairs would prevent you from using a tripod, which is one of the most important piece of gear that I carry around. So if I cannot use tripod and see myself in the camera screen, what's the point of having a flip screen, right? So that's the reason that a lot of people use Sony, this A6400. I haven't bought that gear because although it has really good quality in the image quality, the 4K and a lot of other capacities, but I'm not tempted. I'm happy with my Canon range for now. This is not a sponsored video. I'm just sharing with you my honest opinion as a consumer, and every piece of gear that is my personal investment that I bought for my own use. That is a very honest opinion. Maybe you disagree, but make sure you share with me your favorite piece of gear in the comment box below. In terms of the objectives, or how to call it, lenses, what I like the most is the 50 1.4. It's a prime lens. That is to say, I cannot zoom, so I have to move my camera or move my subject in front of camera to get the right frame. I don't mind because I'm mainly shooting art or shooting myself, so I can either move myself or move the art, so I'm not bothered at all. And I like the 1.4, it's very nice bokeh when I shoot in the dark at night, portraits and, you know, street shots, and I find it very artistic. If you like to shoot very nice and romantic images, it's also very good to have a very wide aperture prime lens, good solid build, very affordable compared to the same quality a zoom lens would cost you a lot more, like 3 times more. Right now what you're seeing is a EFS 17-55 2.8, so I can zoom in. You can see I can zoom in and zoom out very quietly. You don't really hear a lot of like a ching 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 kind of sound. So that is really a desired feature from the Canon EFS range. But I do have a complaint with this lens, is when I shoot over the desk or over the head shots, when I tilt it, then the front element would move and would drop. So it's really inconvenient. I cannot keep it framed without having to have my hand move freely. So it's really kind of annoying. So sometimes I use the Sigma Art range, that is a 18-35, but I don't like it too much because it's heavy. So when I'm shooting over the desk shots, I kind of risk the whole camera falling down onto the art. So what I like the most is a pancake kind of prime lens, so I can shoot very light and it can fit into a very small space. It depends on what kind of art you shoot, what kind of content you create. I cannot tell you you need to buy this lens or that lens. It's really up to you and your kind of needs. And now I would like to talk about stabilization. I think is after the camera and lens is the most important element in your content production. I like those kind of pockets. It's a Manfrotto pocket tripod. I can slip it just in my pocket and nobody even would notice that I'm carrying a tripod, because sometimes when I go to museums, they don't want you to carry tripods or monopods, those kind of things. So it's really handy. Sometimes I just take it out of my pocket and do a quick interview or selfie or time lapse that I would definitely need a tripod to work with. So it's really handy when I need it. And sometimes I would carry a full size, let's say a 1.50 meter tripod. So that gives me more flexibility. You can buy anything. My favorite is a Manfrotto with the central column tilting 90 degrees. And I have a couple of other different kind of tripods. You can buy anyone, any brand, it does the job, but make sure you don't buy the turn to lock kind of tripod legs. I don't like them because look, you turn to lock it, from far you cannot see if it's locked or not. There is absolutely no indication whatsoever. So there was one time I thought I locked it, but I didn't. So I let go of my tripod and the moment I leave it on the floor, it was like shoom, it's like a magic trick. The next moment it was gone, out of sight. It like zoomed out itself and folded on the floor. So I was like, wait a second, what was going on? And then later I realized that it's because I did not lock it. It's my fault. It's not the fault of the manufacturing of the tripod. But if you are clumsy like me, a forgetful, or sometimes stressed or busy, you will forget one day or another. If you have a camera on top, you can easily damage your expensive gears and create a lot of delay in your works and inconvenience you have to bring to fix. And so I like the traditional lock that you can lock with a pedal, whatever you call it. So it's much easier for me to see with my eyes that if I have locked this tripod or not. That's all for the tripods. If you like to do things like walking around in the street art, shooting the street art scene, or doing a lot of gun and run, or doing a lot of walking in the beach, juggling shots, or going to art exhibitions, shooting art fairs, then I would highly recommend you this piece of gear. This is a Benro Phonographer. I also have a Osmo Mobile 2 that I bought in Europe. This one I bought in China, so I don't know if you can access either of the products. And I like the Phonographer. I carry it with me all the time in my bag, and it can fold into a very small size. So this is a full size. And what I like about it is the battery is good. They have a microphone jack. It folds small and it was very cheap. I bought it under $100. And its model is the P1, so Phonographer P1. I don't know if it does mean anything or not, because for different market, they might have a different name for it, but I find it extremely useful. I just put my mobile in here and I can walk around, and whatever I do, even if I'm shaking, walking the stairs, it creates a very smooth shot. Even a child could hold it. As long as you can hold it, you can create a very nice steady cam kind of effect. In the good old times, I used Merlin Steadicam, the pocket one. It's very difficult to operate. I have to say that it took me like half a year to really understand how it works, but this one is much easier, no learning curve whatsoever. Even if you have never used a Steadicam or stabilization before, you will be able to use it, and you just need to remember to charge it, and that's pretty much all you need to do. The next thing I want to talk about is sound. It's super important if you're doing any kind of interview, vlogging, like talking to the camera, doing tutorials. If you want some really high engagement, you want to create a personal brand, I would say show your face, record your own voice, don't just put music, because that's so generic and people don't really have a sense of your personality and your personal trademark. I'm using a Sennheiser MKE-400, I believe that's the model. I also used a Rode stereo, and you can also buy a cheaper Rode mic that is under $50, very easy to use. I have also a Rode lavalier mic that I left in my office, so I cannot show you. The Rode mics are very good quality price, and it's an Australian brand. Make sure that you buy the right plugs, because there are three rings and then there are two rings. If you buy the wrong one, then you need to get the adapter, which is $10, so it's also quite convenient. convenient, but it's better to buy the right kind of plug when you purchase. So the 3-in-1 is for mobile and the 2 is for camera. So if you want to record with your mobile or with your camera directly, it's totally your choice. And now I want to show you another microphone. If you are a potter, ceramic artist, or doing kind of crafts with machines, you know the pain is so noisy in your studio that you cannot really hear yourself even if you talk to another person. And it's really hard to have a clean audio. So I would recommend you to do a voice over using a condenser microphone. What I'm holding is a Blue Yeti Nano. And Nano means it's a little smaller. And also it's a little cheaper, I believe. I bought it under 100 euros. So you can buy it probably around $100. Now it's sold out because of the confinement. A lot of people use it for video conferencing, for Zoom calls and Skype calls because it's a USB, you plug it directly into your computer and it's ready to go. What I like is it has only two options, so I cannot mess it up. Even if you're not familiar with audio gears, just two buttons, I think it's fair to say that you can learn fairly quickly. But if you want really good audio, of course the USB may not be enough. If you have a Canon jack audio recording device, then you need a Zoom H6 or H4n or H5 or whichever. You need another interface, audio interface to capture. That can be extra trouble. So I would say unless you're professional with vlogging, with kind of media production, it's not worth the trouble to get a super ultra professional gear. Usually it is not the gear, if you have at this level, it's not the gear that is blocking your audio qualities, other things. For example, maybe you say, hey, your audio is very roomy, very echoing, like a lot of reverb, if you know this term reverb. Basically, it's the echo that hits the hardwood floor or concrete floor or wall and then bounces it back and forth. So you hear not so a clear audio. You can call it a very noisy, roomy sound. Whichever way you want to call it is not a very great audio. This is because the room is very spacious without a lot of furniture and everything is very hard. So it's like hard walls, hard floors, and hard furniture. And this is not the fault of any microphone. It's totally my fault because I did not treat the room. It's my own kitchen. I don't want to stick the kitchen full of panels, so I didn't do it. If you want, if you have the money and time, you can buy some acoustic forms or panels and stick it to the walls. But mine just kept falling down, so I give up because I have 3 cats and they would like to use their claws on those forms. If you have a way to prevent forms from falling down, I've tried everything. Double glue, glue gun, I tried nails and tapes and they just kept falling down. So I kind of gave up. If you have any other good tips on how to keep them on the wall, make sure you share it with me in the comment box below. That's all for the sound. I have made another video for the light, so I will not repeat myself. I will slip a link in the description below so you see other videos that I'm mentioned in this video. I liked this umbrella light. It's really cheap, really affordable, portable, and I liked this Diva Ring. Diva Ring is a lot more powerful. It does not heat, so in the summer, I would rather use the Diva Ring, and in the winter, when it's actually quite cold, I don't mind to use extra heating, so I'm using the light boxes and the umbrellas to heat my room at the same time doing some lighting. So that's all. As you can see, that's pretty much all the equipment I use. If you have other gears and accessories that you would like to recommend, make sure you share it with our fellow artist creators. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. See you in next.